All right, check it out. We're going to look today at the MA790X-UD4P from Gigabyte, part of their ultra durable series. Incredible motherboard. This is one of their first more dedicated AM3 boards, so it's going to support your Phenom 2s. But of course, it also works with AM2 sockets and AM2 Plus. If you want to throw Athlons in here or Phenom X3 or Phenom X4s, they're going to work as well. But this is a high board. Very nice. Good stuff. First of all, 790X chipset. Is what's qualifying on the North Bridge here. So that gives you a ton of RAID controls, a ton of hard drive configurations. You also have down here the SB750 South Bridge chipset, which gives you even more RAID configurations. You also get a Gigabit LAN over through here. You also get CrossFireX support. As you see, you have two PCI Express X16 slots. They will operate at X8, X8 if you populate two cards. But that does mean you can do two 4870X2s or in the future two 4890X2s or whatnot through this incredible chip that AMD has manufactured, the 790X, which is actually really, really cool. All right, now let's talk about memory a little bit. You have up to 16 gigabytes of DDR2, so you can do 4 gigabyte DIMMs. You got 4 slots in total. Those are going to do native up to 1300 megahertz DDR2, which doesn't really even exist. It's usually 1066 and 1200. 1333 is barely out there, but you can overclock to 1333 if your memory kits are ready to go that high. Now, the memory and the processor in the North Bridge are all communicating using the HyperTransport 3.0 system bus. That is up to 5200 mega transfers per second, so that's the fastest and the latest of the HyperTransport 3.0. You have 8 SATA ports in total on this board. They are all over here. You have 2, 4, 6 right there, and then the other ones are over here in the purple. Pretty much these are going to go off the Gigabyte chip. This is going off the South Bridge chipset, so these gives you RAID 0 and 1 plus JBOD. This one gives you 0, 1, 0, 1 plus 0 plus 1, 5, and JBOD. So you get a few more options through these. These are the ones you want to use because these are the hardware RAID. So if you're going to go for stripping or striping, you want to go use these for storage. These are great for RAID 1, but you can also go RAID 0 through here. These are going to be on a separate chip. Gigabyte just names it as the Gigabyte SATA 2 chip. It says it right there, but I don't know what actual chip that is. If it's a J-Micron controller, I'm assuming it's a J-Micron controller. Also on this board, which is really nice, you have a lot of USB ports. So if you really like USB connectivity, you have a lot. Just looking at the back, you have 2, 4, 6, 8 right there, and it's actually 12 in total. You have another, if you look over here, you have headers down here. These are 2, these are going to be split to 4. So it's an additional 4 USB ports down there, bringing the total to 12, which is a lot. You also have 10-100 Ethernet, going back to the front back panel plate. 10-100 Ethernet right there. 8-channel audio, this is using the ALC889A, which is an incredible onboard audio chip, HD audio, 106 signal-to-noise ratio. It's incredible, 106 decibels, very, very nice onboard audio chip, almost as good as having a discrete card. Again, a bunch of USBs, you got the regular FireWire, you got the small iLink FireWire, you got the SPDIF, both the coaxial analog at the bottom and the optical digital at the top, which requires a Toslink cable. Over here, you do have PS2s, in case you got some older keyboards and mouse. Now let's talk a little about expansion on this board, because there's a little bit of stuff you can do. Taking a look at your slots, we already talked about the PCI Express slots right there for your graphics cards, but you do have 3 PCI Express X1 slots. So one above this PCI Express card down here. So this one's gonna be used probably for audio cards. There is a cutout sort of in the North Bridge heatsink to let an audio card, you know, sit right there. You have 2 extra ones here, and then on top of that, you have 2 PCIs, 2 standard PCIs, which is very, very good. Now, finally, before I let you go, I'm gonna talk about 2 things. The design of the board and hardware stuff, and then on top of that, we're gonna talk about what's in the box. Now, let's talk about Ultra Durable 3. They're using 2 ounces of copper in each PCB. So in here, if you were to be able to zoom in there and get a really good layer of inside the middle of the PCB, they got 2 extra thick layers of copper in there, both for heat and for conductivity to drop impedance and resistance. It's gonna give you a better overclock, better temperatures, and a bunch of other stuff, really good stuff. As far as the board goes, if you look, let's see if I can get you in there, all solid state caps, these are all Japanese made, ferrite core chokes, lower RDSON MOSFETs, 8 plus 2 phase power for the socket, so excellent for overclocking, 2 phases for the memory. You have dual BIOS chips on here, they are down over here, there they are. You got 2 BIOS chips, so if one goes corrupt, you have a second backup that you can switch to, or you can run 2 different BIOS programs on each setting, 2 different CMOSes, and then from there pretty much switch through them, one for gaming, one for overclocking, or one for saving power, one for overclocking, whatever you want. Another thing that's cool on here is the ECAODACC, which is the embedded controller for AMD Overdrive advanced clock calibration. God, it's a big one. Pretty much what that means is that you can overclock from inside the operating system whenever you want with no problems. Lets you adjust all the voltages on the fly without having to reboot or reset. Now, talking about what's in the box, nice eSATA cable. This is gonna go for a bracket that I'll show you in a second. Let me show you how that works. You get a disc with drivers and utilities, you know, good stuff, AM2, AM3. A couple manuals. I'll get back to this in a second. Input-output plate, shield, regular, labeled, not padded, still pretty good. And in here, whoa, a floppy cable. Actually, an IDE cable, never gonna use it. Floppy cable, never gonna use it. Orange SATA cables that look really cool. And here's this, a badge for your case. Now let's talk about this, this is cool. Here's how this works. This is a SATA on one end, Molex on the other. You plug this into your power, you plug this into a SATA port, you put this in the back of your computer. Now what you have is two eSATA ports, right? And you have a Molex, but it's inside out. It's going the wrong direction. So what's that for? It's for this. This is like to make to dock an external hard drive without putting it inside the case. You plug this end, Molex, into the back of the panel, and now you have on this end two SATA power connectors. So you can hook this up to any two hard drives that you want, and you're powering them up. And then on top of that, this is a SATA to eSATA cable. Very cool. So you plug this into the back of your SATA hard drive, this goes into the eSATA, and you just hooked up that hard drive outside of the case. Very convenient feature. I think Gigabyte's the only person that gives you this bracket, which is the only thing you can use that for, and the cables and stuff, so very good stuff. It's the Gigabyte MA790X-UD4P AM3 socket. Good stuff for the Phenom 2s if you're going the Phenom route, which is makes sense nowadays. Saves you a lot of money. It's a good board, and it's great for that. So if you have any questions on it, email me, and I'll see you guys next time. For more information on the Gigabyte MA790X-UD4P, type in G452-1011 into the search engine of any of these major retailers. For Computer TV, I'm Albert.